Welcome to a new test and teardown video. Last week I got this beautiful Fluke 8012A digital multimeter from a flea market, real cheap. And the seller actually said, yeah, it works. But it was super dirty. And it was really looking like trash. So I bought it anyway. I spent an hour deep cleaning this one. And look, I was able to clean away all the dirt and it's beautiful now. Yeah, okay, the plastic here is definitely affected by time. But it's quite nice. The difference between the 8010A and the 8012A, so this is the very rare model 12, and that one got the low range resistor range. So normally you just go into resistor and then you can just go through all the ranges like that. But if you want to take advantage of the low range, then you just push in those two buttons at the same time, and then you get two new ranges, only this and that. So this is 2 ohm or 20 ohm full range. So that will give you now a resolution of 1 milli ohm compared to the 8010A, which is very normal. It has not this feature, and it got 100 milliohms resolution in the lowest range. But the 8010 got a 10 amp plug here, and then you go into current, and then you push the last button, then there will be a 10 amp mode here, and then you use the 10 amp connector. So, but that is not available on this instrument, then it is 2 amp full range. So that is the only difference between the two models. So first I will see if this one works. I'm not going to bore you with all the different ranges and all the different things, but let me just show you. I didn't open this yet, I didn't calibrate anything, and this instrument is about 40 years old or something like that, right? So, look at that, 1.231, and the real input is 1.230. So it is one count, one last count. I mean, this is totally acceptable. I am so happy. And this is supposed to be 100 milliamps. Ah, almost, right? And here's the current. Yeah, I reversed the wires on that one. I'm so sorry about that. But it is super accurate. I love it already. So this is the normal resistance range. Let's look at the lowest range. This is 200 ohm full range. And I see 0.1, so this is 100 milliohm resolution in this normal mode. I'm using a quite thick cable, and it's not that long. This cable is about 17 milliohms, the way that it is right here. And this meter is correctly adjusted, because it should, of course, not show zero, because you got a little bit of cable here. So, so far, so good. Let's just try and take a 0.47 ohm power resistor in a 4-point setup. What you see here is actually temperature variation of this resistor, because I just touched it. See, if I touch it a little bit more, see, it is that temperature dependent, because they are not super temperature compensated and all that kind of funky stuff, because that is expensive. This is just a power resistor, right? Take the same resistor here in the normal mode. It's of course 0.5, and that is perfectly all right because it says 0.47. This is what we would expect, right? So this is the low range mode. I am now in the 2 ohms full range, and put both of them here on the same side and use this 0 to make it almost 0. There's a nice way to do this. It's not super critical or anything like that. So let's try and measure this resistor. So that is a 2 point, of course. So it's not as accurate as a 4 point method, but it says 459. So let's take the same 2 point way and stick it into the other one. So just remember 459. And there you have it, with the same cables and everything. Oh, I realize now that I zeroed the other one with those cables. Oh, I'm an idiot, so of course there is a difference. Of course I need to do a 4 point to have it zeroed the right place. And it's still 459. Ha! Well, that is amazing. So I can actually take advantage of the 1 milliohm resolution of this 40 years old instrument. Wow! That is a little bit impressive. The inside is just absolutely beautiful. A lot happened during the last years of Fluke development. I've also been poking around inside the older models, and I must say there is a big, big change. This is so much cleaner, simpler. It's just one IC here that's doing the LCD and all that kind of stuff. Here's a resistor with ranges. And there's actually also a big, white, thick film resistor in there. That's of course also ranges. That board up here is the low ohm range. The 10 amp model, the 8010A, looks a lot different. This is then the 10 amp module. We got all the low current ranges down here. You see the power resistors, low value resistors for that. And of course the fuse, mains, transformer, and a thick film circuit in here. There's actually a funny thing that you should know. If you buy these overseas from 60 hertz land, you see 50 hertz and 60 hertz here, and there's also on this crystal written 50 hertz. I don't know if I can make you make this visible, but it's actually, of course, this crystal is not a 50 hertz crystal, but this is the crystal you need to use when you're running in 50 hertz part of the world like I am. And it's because you want to sample at a frequency that is dividable by the mains frequencies, because otherwise your reading's gonna flicker. So you want to be in sync with the mains frequencies so you can filter away and make a nice stable readout. So this is a normal trick, and all multimeters can do that. They are more modern instruments. You can even select how many phases you want to be averaging over and then still be in perfect sync with the mains frequencies, because you have mains frequencies in all your cables that's floating around here on your table. They will pick up a little bit and then you will see it. There's actually a little bit of a funny thing with this rectifier here. Look how close it is to this thick film circuit. It's actually touching So that is a little bit weird. I would have put it like a millimeter away, so it's not super critical and all that. And all the shadow switches here in this model, they just work perfectly fine and stable. So I don't need to clean anything. What a lucky, lucky day it was for me to get this unit. There's a little bit of a hand solder thing here. But other than that, I am super happy. Oh yeah, if you look at that. Can you see all the contacts here at the end? That is actually another model where there is a thin, thin, flexible piece of plastic that bends around here and that connects to the LCD. And I am actually happy that I don't have that model because they are known to cause all sorts of problems. This one here is connected on the top here, and here is the glass. And again, I'm so happy this works. I got super high contrast, very, very good readability on this LCD. LCDs don't last forever, like a lot of other stuff, of course. But so far, this one is tip top. So that was all I wanted to show you about my new super nice Fluke. So have a good day, and I hope to see you again tomorrow. Bye bye.